Okay, students, welcome back to our lesson, that is why do organisms reproduce. So now I'll talk about the further topic, that is do organisms create exact copies of themselves. Students, in class 9 you have seen chapter cell. In that cell chapter there was very important part into the cell, and that part is called as a nucleus. I hope you remember this nucleus, which is present in the middle of the cell. And this is called as a nucleus. Okay, what is this exactly nucleus means? This nucleus contains chromatid material. You might be remembering this chromatid material. This contains, and that is called as a chromatin. Okay, chromatin. And whenever there is the time comes for the cell division, okay, there is a time comes for the cell division, this chromatin material starts taking the shape of the chromosome. Okay, this much I hope you are knowing, okay, because this you might have learned in class 9. So this chromatin material, which is present in the haphazard manner, okay, it does not form a shape of a chromosome until it starts its division. Till that it is in the haphazard manner. Whenever the time comes for the cell division, that time what happens, this chromatin material is starting the taking the shape of the chromosome. So what happens in the nucleus, there is a chromatin material which contains chromosome, and this chromosome is the part of the chromosome which is going to forward the information for the inheritance. Students, heredity and evolution, it will be more clearer, but I would like to know you now only. Heredity means what? The transfer of genetic material from the parents to the next generation. Okay, transfer of DNA material or transfer of gene from carries from parents to the next generation, that is called as a heredity. So what happens, a particular part or a particular trait is only forwarded from the parents to the next generation. Understood? So the part which is carrying information to the next generation is called as a gene. Okay, so the segment of DNA, students, you are knowing the DNAs are like this. DNA is one kind of strand. DNA is what? Deoxyribonucleic acid. DNA. Deoxyribonucleic acid. So segment of DNA, particular segment of DNA, which is the part of the chromosome. Students, you are knowing the shape of the chromosome. On the chromosome, there is a DNA, and the particular part of the DNA which is going to be transferred from first generation to the next generation, that is called as a gene. And that process is called as a heredity process or transformation of the gene. This we will see in chapter heredity and evolution. But little bit it is important to know now, because do organisms create exact copies of themselves, the part is going on. So what happens, the information is carrying from parents to the next generation in the form of gene. Okay, students, do you get it? It's a cell. Cell contains nucleus. Nucleus contains chromatin material. This chromatin material acquires the shape of the chromosome whenever the division of a cell is taking place. Okay, and whenever it's time to take the shape of the chromosome, then chromosome has a part. Chromosome is completely, whole chromosome is made up of completely DNA molecule. Okay, DNA, deoxyribonucleic acid. And this DNA molecule, the segment of DNA which is going to carry information from first generation to the next generation, is called as a gene. Okay, so this thing I think is clear for you. Now we will go ahead. Now what happens, whenever this information is carrying from first generation to the next generation, and students, there are two types of cell division, you might be knowing. Cell division, that is mitosis and meiosis. In mitotic kind of cell division, the number of cells are go on increasing. Right, means at a time two means cell are going to be devoid. Okay, and meiosis is what? This meiosis is called as a haploid kind of cell division. Means half number of chromosomes are being here. This process actually you see somewhere or ask somewhere, because this is meiosis process. This is taking place into the sexual reproduction, and this mitosis process is taking place. Students, two types cell division is taking place. We are knowing whenever we are falling somewhere or we are getting cut or we are getting wound, that time we are getting a new skin on it, or our body is damaged. Whenever the body is damaged, it is getting repaired, right? It is getting repaired, and that repairing is done by the cell division, and that cell division is called as a mitotic kind of cell division or mitosis kind of cell division. But whenever there is a case of a sexual reproduction, during sexual reproduction, whenever there is a nucleus divides, means nucleus form the new cell, that time the meiosis kind of cell division is taking place. So it's very important to know meiosis and mitosis. If you want it, you can go somewhere and see. And if you want again mitosis and meiosis, I will make a video separate for you. But here that is not the case, or that is not most important. Here the do organisms create exact copies of themselves? Here we are going to talk about variation and how exactly it is taking place. So mitosis, there are two kinds of cell division, that is mitosis and meiosis. Here double number of chromosomes we are knowing. Ki one cell is there, one cell is taking place, means one cell divides into two cells, right? So we will talk about now do organisms create exact copies of themselves. Now you see students, this is one strand of the chromosome, right? This is one strand of the chromosome. So DNA copying means what? First we will see DNA copying means what. DNA copying means what? Formation of new DNA strand. Okay, formation of new DNA strand. This DNA copying is also called as a DNA replication. Students, you are knowing the word replica. Replica means exact copy. Students, we go for the Xerox copies, photocopies we go, and we are getting the exact copies of ourselves, right? आपला जसा फोटो असतो तसाच फोटो आपल्याला मिळतो, right? So photocopy is what? The Xerox copy is what? The original is we are keeping with us, and whatever copies we want, we are making them. Okay, if one copy is with me and I want 2-3 Xerox copies of particular photo or particular thing, then my original copy is with me. But at the same time, if I want 2-3 copies, then I can take it out. Here also is the same. Means I have my own DNA material. If I want to give a birth for the kids, 2-3 kids, then my copy is with me. At the same time, another copies are going to be created in the form of the my children. Understood? So you have taken birth from your parents, some characteristics you have acquired from your parents. Okay, as you will give birth to your babies, some characteristics are going to be come in your copies. But every time, how Xerox copies is the exact copies, right? Whenever we take Xerox copies, these Xerox copies are exact copies of original Xerox. But here in this copy, the body design is same, but these are not exact copies of an organism. Do we look identical exactly? Our body design is same, students, but do we look exactly like our mother or father? It is not possible, only because here intermixing of DNA material has taken place. So some characteristics are coming from father, some are coming from mother. Understood? So here what happens? The exact copies of DNA is not possible. Understood? So here replication means what? Replica means exact copies. Replica is the proper word. And DNA copying or replication word is used. Formation of the new DNA strand. Students, you are knowing. Here, once again, I will make another diagram for you. You can see, students. See, this is strand and this is also strand. And this is going to make a new DNA copy. If suppose two children are there, then two kids are there, then two copies are going to be made. Two copies are going to be made. But whenever these two copies are made from one DNA, one is original, two copies are made, that time its own material is going to be transferred. But at the same time, due to various factor, and as the particular person is also an individual, it has its own genetic material. Understood? A particular person has transferred the DNA material from the parents, and some characteristics are from parents, from mother and from father. So there what will happen here always, while copying a DNA, there will be always variation. Exact copies we are not going to create. Exact copies are not going to create. It is not possible, because DNA copying is also a biological process. And no biological process is going to be reliable. Reliable in the sense, it is not going to be a exact copies of the parents. It is going to be change. It is going to be have a variation. And that variation only leads to speciation and evolution. That we will see later. But what happens whenever the copies are created, these copies are not exactly, or the same genetic material is never transferred. It is only shown in the movies that father exactly look like its own son. It is not happening in a real life. Never same looking persons are created, never. So only it is said in your textbook, you can read, it is said ki the body designs are same, the blueprint is same, but the exact copies are not formed. Students, see, suppose this is this is our nucleus material, and now it's a time of the cell division. Now what will happen? First the nucleus divides, you are knowing, whenever there is cell division occurs, the nucleus divides, and then cytoplasm material divides, and two different cells are. Now here it will be more clearer for you. So students, so this is first cell. During cell division, what happens? This genetic material means DNA. DNA means chromosome. This chromosome first divides and forms a two different apparatus are required. Means one copy is same here, and from this two copies are created. Means one is same here and another copy is created during this cell division. So whenever this is taking place, that time what happens, whenever this DNA copying is taking place, every time there will be variation. Every time there will be variation, because the DNA material is little bit separated. So every time DNA copies will not create the exact copies of themselves. Every time there will be variation. An extreme, if see, we look similar, if you are two kids of your parents, means you and your brother or sister, then you are looking quite similar to each other, but your cousin and you are quite different than each other, then your generation, your next further generation will be exactly different. Why it is going to be happen? Because of the intermixing of the DNA material. Understood? DNA material means two different materials are going to be combined. So some characteristics are seen from your mother, some are seen from your father, and that is only the idea of variation. And this variation only leads to speciation, means two different, means what will happen again, means see here students, how we were first. When we were I would like to say early man, we are more cleverer than early man, right? Early man's further generation were being very much cleverer than early man. So that, students, what happens, every generation there is a change is going to be takes place. Simply variation means what? The changes are going to be takes place, and these changes are occurring due to the not exactly copying of DNA. And really it is fruitful, because variation is very, very essential, and variation leads only speciation, and evolution is taking place. So see here students, your generation, your parents might be saying ki my child is more clever than me. Why it is so? Because you have a very good, means every generation what happens, the our brain is getting developed. We had first a very small brain, but now it is developed. So every generation what happens, the development is taking place, students. Every generation development is taking place, and development, if it is taking place, then it is normal. If DNA copy, see here one more point is there, if DNA copy is drastically changed, means a lot change if it would be taking place, then lot change will not accepted easily earlier by this bag. And what would happen? That if drastic change would be there, that is not a evolution, that is not a progress, right? So that particular bag or that particular DNA copy which is made from the parents, which is drastically changed, will eventually die. That will not survive. The small changes are acceptable, but a big changes are immediately not acceptable. Okay, by in the evolution process, if a big change would be there, then that change is not a common change. That is some problem, or we can say some hereditary problem. Hereditary diseases are there, students. We will learn next class. So hereditary diseases are there. So here, what happens? If the drastic change would be there while DNA copying, then that change is not acceptable, and that particular new DNA copy, whatever the copy has created, that would die. But here, what would happen? If the small changes are there, if the small variations are there, then it can be survived. Here, I would like to give example. See, if your mother have a blue eyes, and if your father has a black eyes, and if you have got a black eyes, means you have taken a trait of black eyes from your parents. Okay. At the same time, you will have a different shape of your nose, which you will take from your mother. We can take example of a curly hair. If your mother has a curly hair, and if you have got a curly hair, so you have taken a trait of the curly hair from your mother. You have taken a trait of the black eyes from your father. So this is what happens. The variation happens, right? The variation has taken place because exchange of the DNA material has taken place during sexual reproduction, and it leads to variation, and variation leads to evolution. So this is the idea, and really variation is essential to have a new species. Understood, students? So the answer of this question, that do organisms create exact copies of themselves, the answer is no, because during sexual reproduction, chromatin material, means the DNA material, is getting transferred, and during the transformation, during the transfer, what happens, students? Mixing of the DNA is taking place, and that DNA is making, means other, see, we look like our parents, means we have two hands, we have a body structure, means our body structure or body design will be same, but little changes will be there because of the transformation of the DNA material. And so that we are unique, every individual in the universe is the unique. This is the reason, because nobody is like our previous one, because of this combination of the DNA material. So here I have completed that do organisms create exact copies of themselves, and in tomorrow's lecture I'll talk about the importance of variation, which is also going to be quite interesting. And then afterward we will talk about the types of the reproduction, that is sexual reproduction and asexual reproduction. So tomorrow's topics are importance of variation and the types of asexual reproduction. Thank you very much.